Hello, I'm Mr. Arniger, a retired lecturer in Mythology, preaching Christianity and Sikhism. Sikhism is a continuation of Christianity, and Nanak was the second coming of Jesus. And here I'm doing a gospel of Mark 11, verse 15 to 17. Holy Gospel of our Supernatural Father Elohim, Allah, Parbrahm, etc., delivered by Jesus, the First Anointed Christ of the Most High, Living God, living inside us, that makes us alive. Elohim that dwells within us, called Emmanuel. He was the First Anointed Light from our Father, and Satguru stand for Christ. Nanak, the Second Anointed Greatest of all the Christ, because he had to confront the kings and emperors of darkness of Khatri tribal people. He came in 1469 and preached gospel to perfection through five more lives for 150 years. Still, the darkness could not be comprehended. Then our Father himself came in the name of Royal King Gobind Rai. We call Sache Pasha Gobind Rai. Pasha means one who protects your honor, to sort out the stubborn sons of Satan with sword power. Sons have no authority to take the life, but our Father and his philanthropic soldiers, Khalsas, the Puritans, do have. So, enjoy the gospel according to St. Mark 11, 15 to 17. It was almost time for the Passover festival, so Jesus went to Jerusalem. There in the temple, he found people selling cattle, sheep, and pigeon, and also the money changers sitting at their table. So he made a whip from cords and drove all the animals out of the temple. Both the sheep and the cattle, he overturned the tables of the money changers and scattered their coins. And he ordered those who sold the pigeons, "Take them out of here. Stop making my Heavenly Father Yahweh," we call him Brahma, and in Arabic it's called Khudai, etc., house, a marketplace. You know, there are two gods, Demiurge, which we call Potter. You can see with your two naked eye, the Lord of Nature. This is the pot made by Yahweh. We call him Brahma, or in Arabic called Khuda. Somebody is departing, we say Khuda Hafiz. Hafiz means protect you. This will protect you, the Yahweh protects you. And he feed you too, because he has created you. So when he created you, if you are faithful to Yahweh, he will feed you. If you are unfaithful, then you die out of hunger. The chosen people are a demonstration nation of the word. If you understand them, you will understand the nature of Yahweh and also of our supernatural Father, which is of soul inside me, is of Elohim, Allah, Parbrahm. So, you know, in the temple, there were two temples, the two courts, outer court, that was the temple of Yahweh, our Heavenly Father. This is the outer court. Then there was a curtain and there was inner court. Inner court is here in our heart. The covenant was laid on a seat called seat of mercy. So where from the mercy originate? From your own heart. So this is the temple of God, which is the inner temple, holiest of holy. And the seat is here, our heart, where the God rests. he blesses from that seat. So, Heavenly Father Yahweh, a marketplace, his twice born brethren are the hired laborers for the vineyard of our supernatural spiritual father, Elohim, Allah, Parbrahm, etc. And not the spiritually blind once born. You know, these messianic Jews, when they took over the church, you know, they bring in Torah and the old practices. Instead of chief temple high priest, they created Pope. And Pope was worse than temple high priest. Start killing people. Matthew 12, verse 43 to 45 was fulfilled in Pope. And still, he is there. And hope he will be toppled. And not the spiritually blind, once born disciples of the rabbis. You know the word disciple, the root is discipline. You discipline natural boys through the moral law of Moses. They need law, which is milk. But Luke 16, verse 16, there is no more law, no more prophet, no more law, but go by the heart, conscience. Conscience bears fruit. Of the rabbi, remember that the scripture says, my devotion to your house, O God, burns in me like a fire. Or if you love, God is here, is Yahweh, you know, the creator. He brought them into this promised land. And he fed them food, made the promised land a garden of Eden. When the people of Abraham were faithful to Abraham and to Yahweh, they were not Semitic, they were not a Jew outwardly. When they became Jew outwardly, then they broke their covenant with Abraham, because Abraham was not a Jew, he was of Semitic race, and then they won't be fed. I've explained many things about this. That is why Peter killed, burned. My devotion to your house, O God, burns in me like a fire. Or if you love Mammon in your secular works and cheat people as they do in businesses, then you are no good for our supernatural Father Elohim, and you become hypocrites. That is why Peter killed two liars, Ananias and Sapphira, for telling him, for telling Peter, you know, the lies. They had built their houses on, built their houses or the temples of God on lies or sand, and it could not stand the test of gospel truth. The Jewish authorities came back to at him with a question. What miracle can you perform to show us that you are, that you have the right to do this? Jesus answered, tear down this temple, you know, of God, my physical body, Yeshua, built by the Lord of nature, Yahweh, and in 3 days I will build it again. Now, you know, whenever Jesus was speaking, he was giving a comparison between a secular and the spiritual. Remember Matthew 19, Pharisees Sadducee came to test him about the divorce. And they were talking about moral laws, divorce between man and wife, two separate entities. Jesus opened the supernatural field. And he, in supernatural field, our soul is the man. And when he leaves our parent, mother and father, God, and then he joins the flesh in the womb of the woman, then when two are joined together, they are no more two but one person. Flesh, my flesh is slave to my soul. Whatever my soul says, flesh does it. So this is missus of my soul, which is man. So tear down this temple. Jesus said, tear down this temple of God, Elohim, Allah, Parbrahm, my physical body, Yeshua, built by the Lord of nature, Yahweh. And in 3 days, I will build it again. Are you going to build it again in 3 days? They asked. They asked him, it has taken 46 years to build this temple. Again, Jesus made fool of them, you know. But the temple Jesus was speaking about was his physical body. So when he was raised from the dead, his friends, stroke brethren, and not the disciples of the rabbis, remembered that he had said this, and they believed the scripture and what Jesus had said. That means the scripture has been fulfilled. Now they don't believe in scripture, because scripture is for the once born people. We are twice born, and we dominate scripture. Alright, so scripture is under our feet. That's what Jesus walked on water, under the feet. And what Jesus had said, you know, Jesus' knowledge of human nature. Now, Jesus belonged to our supernatural Father, so the Spirit in him was Holy Spirit with capital S, the very Spirit of our Father. So our Father knows as this is the temple of God, and God is inside you, and he knows. If you want to want something, he knows what is in your heart, and you don't need to say prayer, give me this thing, get that thing. He already knows. So in silence he knows everything. That is why Jesus knows the hearts of the people. What is in your heart, he will know before it comes from your mouth. While Jesus was in Jerusalem during the Passover festival, many believed in him as they saw the miracles he performed. In Jesus, we are solidly improving upon our intrinsic mean inside values, and not seeking the praises of men for our extrinsic fame. Extrinsic mean this one, like Billy Graham and all that, you know, people go there to listen to him, but he was Antichrist. Prayer is Antichrist in Jesus. Only spiritually blind do it, and prayer was done under rabbis. There are no more rabbis after John the Baptist. Law and prophets were till John the Baptist, Luke 16, verse 16. So these dark-colored people that you see in churches, they are Antichrist, and that's why they dominate in prayer. After a little while, he will tell the people, bend down and say prayer. 3-4 times this bloody say prayer in the church. And what the prayer does? Nothing. Our Father is not in heaven. He's inside us. So that prayer make no sense. So much so, you know, in Oxford University I go, they have Nicene Creed in Lady Margaret Hall Church. And it's everywhere, you know, where they say Christ died, Christ rose on third day. I laugh at them, you know, that Christ stand for his word. How can he die? And I asked the dean of the Oxford University, who died on the cross, Jesus or Christ? He said, personally, if you ask me, it is Jesus who died, not Christ. But officially, I can't say. Officially mean, in Jesus, it should be yes or no, not wavering. He was wavering, you know. So that type of knowledge there, because they haven't got it from our Father. They're learning things from the books. Books can't give you. This living gospel is for the living in spirit, people who speak from their heart and not from the book. That is why Jesus said, don't take money, tunic, or even scrip with you. Scrip means scripture, Bible. Don't take it with you when you go on preaching gospel. Everything gets written over your heart. Gospel cannot be written on in ink on paper. So Bible is dead letters. No gospel in that one unless you understand it. But Jesus did not trust himself to them. That means those people, they were doubting type, you know, in Jerusalem. They wanted to test him, but not believing. Remember that born blind person? They knew he was used to be blind, and Jesus had healed him and opened his eyes because they did not want to admit the defeat that he is a superior to them. And that is why even seeing him, they were denying, you know, that, hey, this is not the same man, he's a different man. Whereas the people were saying he's the same man. He himself was saying the same man, parents were saying the same man. But still they were not admitting the defeat. So they are blind, blind guides of the blind. And when Jesus told them, blind guide of the blind, a Pharisee overheard him. Hey, you call me blind? Jesus said, if you say you are not blind, then if you do things wrong, you are committing blasphemy, not sin anymore. Sins are transgression against the moral law under ignorance. So he was not ignorant, that Pharisee. So he was committing hypocrisy. That's why Jesus condemned hypocrisy most. Anybody who talk about sin or anything like that in church, he is straight away antichrist. He doesn't know, because in Jesus we expose hypocrites and nothing more. There was no need for anyone to tell him about them, because he himself knew what was in their hearts. Jesus possessed the very spirit of our supernatural Father, and therefore he had extraordinary sense. And hope this will make sense. And I wish we had customers for this knowledge. They are rare. That's why Christ Thomas said, one in 1,000 and two in 10,000 will know gospel. And his last logo, 114, unless a female become a male, you cannot enter into the royal kingdom of God. Because a female is one who do what the rabbi tell them to do. Like Saul was female when he was dominated by his rabbi Gamaliel. And that's why he changed his name to Paul when Jesus set him free from that yoke. And he became the master of his own destiny. But the same body was Saul. He remarried it to make it Paul. Thrice born, because he got the very spirit of God. So many things there. I wish we had customers, and please try to propagate